questioning on, you know, in this airport, they assume everyone is a foreigner.
Why would they assume everyone's a foreigner? Hardly makes any sense. Will you please give that phone a break?
It's my laptop world.
I told you not to get in that iPhone.
In this day and age, everybody has an iPhone.
Exactly.
I don't.
That's because you don't want one.
I need to get on my plane now. I can't take all this drama. Better yet, I need to buy my own plane.
Who are you?
Honey, it's Sandra. I'm your wife.
My wife.
Yes, dear.
We're married.
Sometime soon. after her.
I think we should mind our own business.
She probably needs our help.
You know better, Dad. The mom decides to do something, there's no stopping her.
Hey. What's your name?
Tina.
Hi, Tina. I'm Amanda. So, are you here with anyone?
I'm waiting for someone.
I don't think anybody's gonna come anytime soon.
I'm patient.
Okay. Well, if you need anything, I'm just over there. All right. Nice talking to you.
Goodbye.
Well, she's a bundle of joy.
Is she lost?
I don't know. She doesn't have any luggage or anything, but there must be a reason why she's here.
Well, I guess we'll be spending Easter here.
Did someone say Easter? In your choice of words, I sure hope you're referring to the Easter Bunny and not some religious rubbish about some Jewish rabbi dying on a cross.
I guess they don't go to church, huh?
For what purpose? So someone can exploit my meager salary?
I don't think that's what church is all about.
Hello? Other people who prefer not to hear about church are sitting here.
Listen, we're all stuck here. Best we make good use of our time together, considering we will never exactly see each other again.
I would rather the storm just passed so I can be on my way. I don't mix with the lower class.
How are you still alive with a mouth like that?
What's wrong with my mouth?
It's filthy, that's what.
There will be no fighting this year for my watch.
There's no fighting here, officer. We're just cold and a bit frustrated.
I have eyes everywhere. Keep the peace.
Hi. Does anybody have any spare change? I would love to get a hot French vanilla from the vending machine.
Don't give this man any of your money.
Why not? He looks like he needs it.
He's just gonna use your money and buy drugs.
Right. You realize I hear you, right?
So, do you do drugs?
No. And I don't drink or smoke either. I'm a Christian, just like you.
A Christian on the road begging?
I don't have much, but I am happy.
How can you find happiness in that pitiful state?
Leave him alone. I can relate to what he's saying. I learned a long time ago that life is much more than just acquiring stuff.
None of you know the value of life. We're here to make money. Lots of money. It's the only way to be happy.
You don't seem happy.
Don't be fooled by my expression. I'm very happy, just very annoyed right now.
And alone.
Excuse me?
Man, you are a lonely woman.
I knew trying to travel on the eve of Easter would have been a bad idea.
We've been saving for this trip all year long.
We just have to wait to accumulate enough money to buy the tickets.
There goes my foot. I bet that both of you are working and can't make ends meet.
I lost my job 6 months ago.
Ouch! That's terrible.
Yeah, it's been tough.
You know what? I bet I put a strain on your relationship that your wife or girlfriend has to foot all the bills.
She's my wife, and we're doing okay.
She wants you to believe that.
We're doing okay, right?
We can talk about this when we get home.
Oh, we need to talk about this?
Maybe.
I thought you were fine paying for all the bills and stuff. Until I could find a job.
I didn't think it would take this long. It's been 2 months and you have not put an application out anywhere.
You've been carrying this for 2 months?
I'm just saying that I need help. And you would rather be sitting at
don't believe this.
Let's talk about this when we get home.
You've said enough. I need to use the bathroom.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do I know you?
I'm your wife.
My wife.
That's right.
We're married. You can remember something like that.
Grandma, I am certain to know about them.
So
entire life being human. That's how I feel about Jesus Christ.
Great. Another Jesus person.
I'm just giving you something to think about.
You know what? You have enough to think about with that husband of yours. What's wrong with him? Is he schizophrenic or what?
He has Alzheimer's disease.
What's that?
It's a mental disease that affects 1 in 85 people over the age of 65. It causes confusion, aggression, irritability, long-term memory loss, mood swings, eventually death.
That's sad.
You say that with absolutely no emotion.
Maybe because I can't relate.
You've never had anyone with a terminal illness?
Not to my knowledge.
What about your parents?
I was abandoned at the age of 2. I'm my own mother and father. So everything you're looking at right now is all me.
It's not much.
I'm better off than everybody here.
You will still die. And strangers will dress you, put you in a box and cover you with dirt in a government cemetery, just like everyone else.
You know what? I would prefer not to talk to you anymore.
Does this man belong to anyone? I caught him relieving himself in the cafeteria.
Ew.
I thought it was the bathroom. And why would they put a urinal in the cafeteria?
Man, I'm not gonna ask me to keep an eye on him. I would have put him outside if not for this storm.
Yes, sir.
Why do you keep coming back?
Where am I gonna go?
Good point.
So you don't believe in the Easter story?
Easter is just another holiday. Time off to spend the kids and go have some drinks with a few friends. There is nothing more to life than to enjoy the fruits of your labor. I think that's in the Bible.
Oh yes. There's a lot more to life than just that.
What would you know about living?
Well, I know what it's like to have everything. And I know what it's like to lose everything. A fine walking both sides helps me to understand and appreciate the value of things.
You don't sound like someone who should be on the streets.
Well, I like helping people. And I find people on the street are more open to my help than those who can help themselves.
So, you're not homeless.
If you mean by definition that I don't live anywhere, yes, I am homeless.
You're not poor and destitute?
Man, it's not money that people need. It's what it can buy and what it can do. If there was no need to pay for stuff, why would you need money? If you had everything you ever needed without having to pay for it, what then is the value of money?
Well, you should ask this rich and obnoxious over there.
Perhaps I should, and I will when I get back.
Is that a homeless guy in here?
It almost seems like the new kid is coming.
That's creepy.
Grace, if you had everything you ever needed without having to pay for it, what is the value of money?
Leave me alone, please.
You see, when you act like that, it only highlights your loneliness.
I am not lonely.
You travel alone every holiday.
You wouldn't know that.
I know more than you think.
Just leave me be.
your money will perish with you, right?
You know what? You look like you could do some. If I give you $100, will you leave me be?
Don't be fooled, Grace. I don't need your money.
How does that bum know my name?
Tina, right?
Yeah.
When did you run away from home?
Your daughter has a big
mouth. She didn't say anything. It's pretty obvious now. You're here alone, and you're not traveling. How did you even get into the terminal?
That was easy. I just walked close enough to an adult coming in. The security guard is not very
smart. Yeah, I figured that out too.
We children had to teach our parents how to treat us sometimes.
I don't think that's how it works.
The Bible says, a little child will lead them.
You're quoting scripture out of context.
I don't think so.
Parents have the responsibility of taking care of their children.
We have a responsibility too.
What did they do to you?
I don't really want to talk about it.
It might.
I'll still pass on that.
Well, tomorrow's the day Jesus was crucified so that we would live forever. Are you excited or what? We get to relive this amazing supernatural event all these centuries later.
It's just another day.
Oh, it's more than that. It's the day Jesus died for the sins of the world.
People actually believe that?
Yes, and you will too.
I doubt that. And shouldn't you be in some garbage instead of harassing law-abiding citizens? And where is that stupid security guard?
Leave the poor guy alone. I like him.
This time of year is very sad for my family.
Oh, why is that?
Because my grandmother died.
Oh, my. Come join my family.
Tina? The way we perceive death sometimes leads to unnecessary pain. Right, Phil?
I'm not so sure I understand what you're talking about.
Your previous wife.
Previous wife? You had the audacity to accuse me of holding back information, and you were married before?
She died in a car accident.
How do you know so much?
I read a lot, and I remember faces.
It's been 15 years.
And I still remember Phil.
How did you get through that?
I was angry at God. Found no comfort, nor peace, until I met Amanda. That changed everything. And how we met was nothing short of a miracle.
It was here, in this terminal.
I was taking a trip, thinking that a change of scenery could help. If it did, I would have come back home and taken my own life. But God had other plans.
Sweet story.
When you get to be my age, you realize that dying young can be a blessing. I am so lost in my own mind that most of the time that it burdens me. And burden for my wife, too.
Sometimes life comes into clear focus, and the answers are easy. We should embrace those times.
But sometimes life gets tough, too. And we learn to endure. But it's important that we remember God's promise that He will always be with us, and that it's very real.
He was never there for me.
There was never a time He wasn't caring for Sheila.
I do not know how He knew my name, but I tried to pursue it. It didn't work for me.
You were pursuing a formula to escape poverty, and it was not God's will for your life.
I was struggling. I could not pay my bills or send my kids to school.
Your motives, they were not pure.
Whatever.
Did you know what I think? I think we're all here for a special purpose.
I wonder what that would be.
We all have our own stories to tell, and we should really learn from each other.
I just want to go.
Sooner or later, you're going to realize you're not shutting the world out. You're simply shutting yourself in.
You sound so educated. What are you doing on the streets?
Well, I go where I'm needed most. And on that note, I'll catch you guys later.
I am tired of chasing you through this airport. We're going to put you off for good this time.
I feel a strange sensation that I'm supposed to know him.
I thought I was the only one.
Tell me about your first wife.
We should force him to talk about it, Mom. He's still hurting, especially here with all these people.
You're
right. That's okay, honey.
The horse is out of the gate anyway.
You really don't have to.
Her name was Caroline. She was sweet, and we met in college. We fell in love. It was a beautiful wedding, just 15 people. We got married the year we graduated. My life was perfect, except that I stopped going to church, and my personal walk with God was reduced to formality. I guess he thought that I idolized her. And maybe I did. So it took her. I guess we don't mind when God takes someone we love, but how He takes them makes it so hard to come to terms with. I went to the scene of the accident. I could not even identify her. Even now, I'm so angry with God. But I tried to suppress it because He had blessed me with you.
I'm the one who's blessed.
I can relate. God took both my babies, Thomas.
Oh my, how they die?
They didn't die. They just left.
I don't think that's the same thing.
It felt terrible.
Come on, good news, ladies and gentlemen. The weather is clear enough, so you should be in your cars for the next 14 hours.
14 hours?
Yeah! That was a bad storm. I have not seen anything like it. But how about taking to the control of people from outside, huh? Follow me.
I'm too old for that.
Excuse me, ma'am, who are you?
I'm your wife, Sandra.
Sandra, my wife, Sandra. For some reason, I can't remember that.
something.
Let's not.
My sentiment exactly.
You two atheists will one day know that there really is a God.
If there is, why won't he show himself?
Happy Easter, everybody.
Brother.
I brought you some presents.
Where'd you get them? From the garbage can?
Very funny. Humor's good medicine, so go right ahead in my experience.
How are you able to afford these gifts? Really?
From all that I gathered here.
You'd spend all that on strangers?
Of course, that's all money can do. I have no use for it otherwise. And we're friends, not strangers.
We spent the last 2 days in the same spot together.
That's right.
Doesn't mean we're friends.
Everything is scattered about me.
Oh, yours is very special, but it's not here yet, okay? You.
What is it?
It's only one way to find out.
You want me to open it now? Here?
Today's the day, Phil.
I don't understand.
Read it.
How do you get this?
It doesn't matter. It's not important.
What is it, honey?
It's a letter from one of the biggest accounting firms in the world. They want me to come in for an interview next week.
Does that mean our days of poverty, eating chicken bats and cereal every day, are over?
Calm down, honey. Let me get the job first.
Wow! I can't believe this!
Seriously, who are you?
Is it obvious? He's an Easter Bunny!
Oh, wow. I look like a rat to you.
So, this is good news. And I guess the details will figure itself out.
I still don't understand how a homeless man can have a letter like that.
Leave it alone, honey. I don't care.
What is this?
Oh, it just opened.
Seriously, what is this?
You've been asking for a raise, right?
I've been working here for over 5 years, and they have never given me one.
You never needed it until now.
So, this check is real. Hold up. It can't be real. Don't you see that this degenerate is playing with your heads? I'm keeping this check.
It's not a guaranteed fix, but it's a start. Let's go. He's waiting for us outside.
Children, I just love them. And I wouldn't want her to be here for this final lesson all of you need to learn.
What are you talking about?
What Easter is really all about.
You won't get away from me this time.
Wait a minute. What are you doing? Is all this necessary?
Shut up. You are the one who said it crucified. You all wanted him dead, right? You all wanted to be rid of this man?
I don't understand.
Stop!
Listen, now this man was sentenced to die, and the only way to save him is one of you takes his place. Now, which one of you would like to take the place of this man? Final call for the brave soul who will allow this man to walk out of here free. Just as I thought.
I think we're all set.
really like this hot French vanilla.
Wait, just a minute. You mean to tell me that this is what you are? Hiding under all these dirty and torn clothes?
Well, this is a party. All that was for a separate occasion.
It took us a while. Well, we finally figured out who you really are.
Not everybody does.
If you're really Jesus, why don't you tell me why my life is so, so miserable?
You know what, Grace?
Do I look like I know what?
You're miserable because you choose to live outside of my presence. Never to leave those who are mine, and I know all my sheep, and I know those who try really hard to live outside of my love. But I haven't changed. It is still my desire that everyone and all of you, be saved.
Happy Easter, Grace.
Happy Easter, Sid.